Welcome everyone. Today I am going to discuss a very important topic of a chapter, redox reaction, which is there in your boards in JEE and as well as your NEET syllabus curriculum. So the topic which I am going to discuss from the redox reaction is a very important reactions, or I would say type of reactions. The reactions are called disproportionation reactions. Okay. Now, the disproportionation reactions, let's say it's a very important kind of reactions. Let's say you have an element and it is A, okay, and this A element undergoes a reaction element and it forms two different products, where the oxidation state of A is basically, let's say initially in the reactant oxidation state was something X, okay, and in the product the two oxidation state of the elements A, let's say one is A, another one is B. Now here you can find out that maybe that A is lesser than X. If A is lesser than X, that means this may be the oxidation, if this may be the oxidation or this may be the reduction. This may be the reduction. That means that in a reaction in which an element A is simultaneously undergoes oxidation and reduction, this type of reactions is called a disproportionation reaction. Okay. Acha. So let's take an example. Now, there are very simple example. Like we talk about first hydrogen peroxide decomposition. Hydrogen peroxide decomposes into water molecule and oxygen. Okay. Now let's calculate the oxidation number of oxygen in the all elements. Here, since it's peroxide, the oxidation number is -1. In water, the oxidation state is -2. And in this pure oxygen, oxidation state is 0. Now you can find out that one place the oxidation state is going from -1 to 0. In another molecule, the oxidation state is going from -1 to -2. So -1 to 0, that means what it is doing? It is releasing the electron. So this process will called oxidation. And again, you can find out that oxygen is going from -1 oxidation state to -2 oxidation state. That means it is undergoing a reduction. So this process will term as reduction. So what is happening in this reaction? In hydrogen peroxide decomposition, simultaneously the hydrogen peroxide is decomposing into water molecule and oxygen molecule, and in this case where the oxygen was in -1 oxidation state, it is simultaneously getting oxidized and reduced, and it is forming -2 oxidation state and 0 oxidation state. So basically you can think in this way, that this is an intermediate oxidation state. The element can go to the highest oxidation state and to the lowest oxidation state. You can think in this way, these reactions. Okay. Now the opposite of this reaction, the opposite of the disproportionation reaction is called comproportionation reaction. Opposite is called comproportionation reaction. Okay, so what happens in case of the comproportionation reaction? Here, from the two different oxidation states, you end up with an intermediate oxidation state. Like let's say from A and B, you are getting to A. So from B to X, so if X to B is the reduction, then forming B to X will be oxidation and forming A to X will be reduction. So this is an example of a comproportionation reaction. Let's look at an example of a comproportionation reaction. So what happens? Example. Okay. Let's say you in the lead batteries, there is a spontaneous reaction happens, and it involves this reaction: lead plus lead oxide, sulfuric acid will give you lead sulfate and water. Okay, acha. Now here the lead, pure lead, is in zero oxidation state. In lead oxide, lead is in plus 4 oxidation state, and in lead sulfate it is in plus 2 oxidation state. So what is happening? Simultaneously, from 0 it is converting to plus 2, and again from plus 4 it is getting converted to plus 2. So 0 to plus 2, this is the oxidation process, and from plus 4 to plus 2, it's a reduction process. So what is happening? From two different oxidation state, the lead is converting to a intermediate oxidation state. Now this kind of reaction is called a comproportionation reaction, and this is basically opposite to the disproportionation reaction. Okay, now let's look at another example of a disproportionation reaction. Okay. Phosphorus. Plus phosphine plus H2PO2 minus. Now here this is pure phosphorus, so here phosphorus will have zero oxidation state, okay, and here phosphine, it is minus 3 oxidation state, whereas in this phosphorus is plus 1 oxidation state. Now simultaneously the phosphorus is converting to going to minus 3 oxidation state, and it is going to plus 1 oxidation state. Okay, now 0 to minus 3 is the reduction process, and 0 to plus 1 is the oxidation process. Okay, so this reaction is basically your one disproportionation reaction of phosphorus in alkaline medium. Okay, alkaline medium. Okay, now my objective is this, in this question, is that what will be the equivalent weight of P4 in this reaction. This is my question. What will be the equivalent weight of P4 in this particular reaction? Because what we know from our knowledge and experience is that for a redox substances undergoing redox reactions, in that case, the equivalent weight is basically molecular weight divided by number of electrons changed. Okay, number of electrons exchange. Okay, right. Let's say if I talk about a reaction, if I have oxalate ion C2O4-2, it is converting to carbon dioxide and it releases 2 electron. It releases 2 electron. Okay. So now, since it releases 2 electrons, so for oxalate ion, the equivalent weight is basically molecular weight divided by 2. But if we look at that reaction, if we look at this reaction, in one case, phosphorus is undergoing this 3 electron change, 3 electron reduction, and here it is undergoing 1 electron oxidation. Now my point is here is that which one we will consider here? We will divide the molecular weight of phosphor P4 by 3 electron, 3, or we will divide the molecular weight of P4 by 1. That is a question here. So this is a little bit tricky thing, but it's very simple. Let me tell you how you can do that. Okay, so to do that, first what we need is basically we have to write the balanced reaction, balanced form of that reaction. Okay, let's look at that balanced form. So what is the balanced form? The balancing technique I will discuss later, but let's first write down the balanced form of that reaction. Okay, so the balanced form is P4 plus 3 sodium hydroxide plus 3 water, that will give you phosphine plus sodium biphosphate, NaH2PO2. Okay, now so definitely here phosphorus is -3, yes, phosphorus is +1, and here the phosphorus is 0. Okay, acha. Now we will separate out the both reactions. Okay, so first is the P4 is getting converted to pH3, so it is going 0 to -3, and in next case it is getting converted, P4 is getting converted into NaH2PO2 +1, 0 to +1. Okay, acha, here in this case, so it is P4. Okay, it is P4. So for one phosphorus, so in this reduction reaction, this is the reduction reaction, and this is the oxidation. So in this reduction reaction, what is happening? It is going from 0 to -3. That means for one phosphorus, the electron change is 3. Correct? For one phosphorus, it is electron change is 0 to 3. So for 4 phosphorus, the electron change will be 3 into 4, which is 12. So total 12 electron is changing from, it is when it undergoing reduction from P4 to pH3. Again, for here, in this case, for one phosphorus, the electron change is 1. So for 4 phosphorus, the electron change will be 1 into 4, that is 4. So there will be 4 electron change. Okay, so total is here 12 electron change in this case, and another one is the, in this case it is a 4 electron change. Okay, acha, now so what is the equivalent weight then? The equivalent weight of P4 is equal to, so what we will do, we will take this one also, we will take this one also, so we will consider this 4 electrons also, we will consider this 12 electrons also. So what we will do, equivalent weight of P4 is basically molecular weight molecular weight of P4 divided by 4 plus molecular weight of P4 divided by 12. So what is the calculation? So molecular weight is P4, phosphorus is 31. So 4 multiplied by 31 divided by 4 plus 4 multiplied by 31 divided by 12. Now if you do the calculations, you will get 31 plus 10.33, that will give you 41.33. So from this disproportionation reaction, what we have calculated, the equivalent weight of phosphorus is 41.33. Okay, acha. So this is what a disproportionation reaction is. And so what is a disproportionation reaction? Let's a quick recap. A disproportionation reaction is a reaction where from an intermediate oxidation state, you are going to two different oxidation state, and that element is simultaneously oxidized and simultaneously reduced. Okay. So opposite of disproportionation is the comproportionation reaction, where from two different oxidation state, the element will go to the one intermediate oxidation state. Okay. Now how we can balance this, since the equivalent weight of any redox substances is basically nothing but the molecular weight divided by number of electron exchange in that particular process. Okay, so how we will do this, how will you calculate the equivalent weight of an element which is undergoing the disproportionation reaction, because in both cases the electron change are different. Okay, so what we will do in this case, we will calculate the total number of electron change is happening during the process. Now when it is done, then what we will do, then the molecular weight of the element divided by 4 plus the molecular weight of the element divided by the 12, that is the total number of electrons from the both process, one is oxidation process and one is the reduction process. Okay, so if I calculate, I will get the corresponding equivalent weight. So this is the way you calculate the equivalent weight of an element which is undergoing the disproportionation reaction. Okay, so this is all from your disproportionation reaction part. Okay, so if you like this video, so don't forget to subscribe and share with your friends, and if you have any question, just write in the comment section. Thank you everyone.